suppose you dropped something, so your packaging is hit by whatever, some
the
force.
Floor.
That force has to go somewhere. It has to do something. Okay, if you don't make it do, it will just keep on kind of transmitting from packaging to whatever is inside, and then it will do the work of breaking it. Okay, so do you want the bottle to break?
No.
So you have to make it do something else so that the bottle doesn't break.
Like
it's like if I am very naughty, you will say, "Daddy, don't do these naughty things. Do this work." Then I'm doing some other work. I'm not doing the naughty things. Right? So that is. I'll give you one more analogy. You have helmets. Okay, they're the cycle or bikers. The helmets that they wear, they are actually called crash helmets. What does it mean? It means when they fall or hit their head against something, the helmet is supposed to crash, break into small pieces. Why?
It'll take the energy.
It will take all the energy of the hitting to breaking it. Now, if all the energy is spent into breaking the helmet, then it can't break the head. It is like used up in that sense. As in, the energy is transferred to something else. So same way you'll have to think about your packaging whenever it hits something. For example, in this, okay, one of the simplest problem is that it is too tightly packed. Now if anything hits here, that is immediately going to this whole matter, and since it has nowhere to go, what will it do?
The glass will break.
No, in this paper packaging, suppose I hit it hard here, okay,
it will go in.
The force is going in, but does it have any thing to do inside? No. So it will again kind of try to do something, and that will tear the packet. But let's say the same packet you fill only 2/3.
No, in that this jar is there. It's not a packet.
Oh, this is not a packet. But okay, I'm taking that example.
In this the jar is there.
I'm taking that example. Suppose this is a packet. Okay, you don't fill it fully. Then if there is a force, what will the force end up doing?
It will push it to the other.
It will move the food, whatever, the powder inside. So it will not damage the packet. The force has been used up to move the stuff inside the packet. Right? But if it is tightly packed, then it will spread, the force will spread onto the powder and back to the packet, and it will break
the
packet.
So if like the... I think one thing is like, if suppose the I don't know if packet filled, but suppose if it's this much filled, I should keep it like this only, not roll it like this. And
then so it's back to not being
I think
totally
that's packed. What, this is how Amiram was packing it, he was rolling it like this and thing. That's why maybe last few packets all have torn.
Yeah, so you keep the powder in it should be able to move.
So like this. And then if this much powder is there, then this much.
उतनी जगह की भी ज़रूरत नहीं, इतनी सी जगह भी बहुत है.
Yeah.
See,
like,
it's not
this
that
will
it
be
means.
Like this. So then.
Yeah. So then you have to see.
Suppose this much powder.
Yeah. So anytime there is some force, if with that force the powder moves, then the movement of the powder takes the force and not the.
But
packet.
Does it make sense to put it in a double packet? That in case it tears, at least.
No, that is a different thing. That is like you are saying, na, in case the outside, that has nothing to do with physics. That's called redundancy. Where if one thing fails, something else is there to say that fails, something else. So that is a redundancy concept. That's a different one. That's got nothing to do with physics.
So no. Then in glass jar also, then there should be more gap here.
That's okay, but that's not so important. Why? Because gap glass is more solid.
So it will impact the glass, not inside.
If it's impacting, anyway, it's the powder movement is hardly anything.
So then how do you safe pack a glass jar?
So here, it's not the contents which will break the glass jar. In your case, if it's fully packed powder, then it's the powder which is actually breaking your packet.
In a paper packaging.
In a glass jar, the powder itself will not break the glass jar. It's the outside impact on the glass itself. So before the impact reaches the glass, you have to make the impact go somewhere else, like your head.
So
in
does
an
the
accident,
stuffing of thing. So
yeah.
This doesn't help.
What is inside this?
This jar, exact same is inside.
Yeah, but what is between this paper and
this
the glass jar?
Cardboard. This one.
So that is maybe not sufficient. So what you can do is, first around the glass jar you can have strips of paper.
Okay.
Have you seen people packing with strips of paper?
Their phone is ringing.
I've seen even in Amazon, I've seen certain times. Or sawdust or something which is...
But what if like this and then around this there's...
You can do the other way around.
Like...
Strips of paper. So what?
जैसे इस डब्बे में आपने वो paper stuff.
Now you put newspaper के stuffings all around this. Like how the glass jars come.
So will the newspaper break then?
No. Newspaper doesn't make, but because it is not packed, it will move.
But something has to break, na? Otherwise.
नहीं नहीं, not something has to break.
So आपा.
Something
has.
Suppose
like this paper.
हाँ.
Yeah. Suppose I put this. And then around, like all around it.
All around it.
But all this will not
it has
break.
To be all around.
All around.
Suppose this is directly touching this, then
it, if
the
it hits here, if by chance it hits here, then the force will. But it's here, it will still not hit break, but this side it will break.
So it has to be all like around. All the sides.
Yeah.
But the paper will transmit the hitting energy to the glass. No?
Yeah, but paper is not stiff, okay? See, if you push my hand here, push, see, it goes like this. But now push.
Ow!
Push, I didn't say it. See, now this whole thing is getting transferred. Right? But if it is all crummy, push. So it is folding. So what happens is, then the energy goes in folding the paper. Because the paper is all loose inside. That's why they put strips of paper. They use shredder to shred thin strips and then they put it. Newspapers, you can just...
Does it have to be newspaper? It can be this cardboard also, since I have so much of it.
You'll have to experiment. I also don't know. People put different things, even put cotton
wool.
Maybe
small pieces of that.
Basically, the idea is not to create one solid mass. Because then the solid mass will quickly transfer. If it's all woolly or cottony, even the bits of paper, then when some impact is there, it will just go... It'll go in rearranging that because it's not solid. No? Like this is too solid.
Mm.
Though there is a cushion because of its. So again, here what is this doing is when you press it, this gets pressed. So to that extent, it is giving a cushion.
Mm.
The energy goes in compressing this. Like in
if you punch in
a pillow, it doesn't hurt. If you punch on a wall, it hurts. Why?
Compress.
Yeah, you end up compressing the pillow, but you don't compress the wall. It's already hard. There's nothing to compress it on. It's the same principle. So when you put it like a woolly matter, papers or even wool itself or sawdust or anything of those kinds, which is woolly, then it goes in compressing. Then the body won't reach.